You're watching the Fox 5 Morning News at 9.
Okay, so it's an okay time of year to actually get booed, all right? This is a thing, you guys. If you get booed, which means, you know, at your front door, someone knock, 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 and then they run, and then you get a treat, it's actually called getting booed. Neighborhoods are doing this all over San Diego and likely all over the country. So here to talk all about it is the Family Entourage. We've got Kelly and Mei Ling. You guys put some great ideas up on your website. So I got to tell you, first things first, have you both gotten booed yet?
That's how I first found out about it. It was so fun. We got booed, and I was like, what is this? Okay, we got to get on this trend.
And it's really easy because once you do that, there should have a card inside that explains how to do it again to the other neighbors. We got booed over the weekend. And so what happens is somebody knocks and then they run. And I have to tell you, it was hilarious because everybody has Ring doorbells now. So you have the camera and the kids will say, Mom, well, we can see who did it. So my son goes, I've got to put on a disguise.
What?
And he goes to our, we have a Halloween bin, and he puts on a top hat and a mask and he's like booing the neighbors. I mean, it was hilarious. So this is something that can be really fun to do in the month of October. You guys have affordable ways to do it because I do think it becomes a thing where you're like, well, what are we going to put in this boo bag? Mm-hmm. So talk about some of the ideas that you have that may not just be sweets, you know, for everyone in the neighborhood.
Absolutely. You know, one of the things you do is if you want to boo your own kids or maybe relatives is get them costumes, pajamas that double as costumes. Hannah Anderson has these great glow-in-the-dark pajamas. The kids are actually wearing some of them as well.
So cute.
So they can be worn as, again, pajamas, costumes, or my kids love wearing them all throughout the year, right? Every day, just play.
This is genius because then once the kids are done trick-or-treating, they just go straight to bed.
Yeah.
There's like, we forgot about the night routine. Just brush your teeth. Hopefully you remember that part after all the candy, and then you go to sleep. Genius.
And
that is so smart.
And the Hannah Anderson pajamas are so soft. You know, I think that's one of the things,
too,
a lot of times with costumes is that the kids only wear them for 10 minutes because they're so scratchy. But my kids love these because they're so soft. And they also have fun accessories you can pair them with in your boo basket, too.
Oh, that's a great idea. Okay, is there a couple of things that you want to maybe for the older? You know, if you wanted to boo your neighbors and maybe they don't even have kids, it's a fun way to get them in on it, right?
No, I agree wholeheartedly with you. Maybe we want to up that neighborhood, do a little home decor.
Okay.
So we love all of this is from Paulson Hill. I think it's so great, maybe even have a significant other that you're booing, You know, instead of fresh flowers, maybe you do succulents in a pumpkin, something that can last a little bit longer, set that on their doorstep, super great. You know, buy a pumpkin pack, separate it out, so it's still under like $20 or so. Get these cute little pumpkins, just like that. Or pair it with a muffin mix or your favorite recipe, then maybe you can go over and do this together.
Gosh, Trader Joe's right now. I walk in there, I'm like, I don't even like pumpkin, and I leave with like eight pumpkin things in a cinnamon broom. Who needed that? I didn't, but here we are.
So many free printables. I love this. A scavenger hunt your neighborhood. Then maybe team up with your neighbors. Who has eyeballs out? Who has this? Who has that? You know, lit pumpkins. All this from Balsam Hill, which we just love because it helps the neighborhood look good, too.
Yes. Are there boo bag rules? Like, what are the rules? Are there any rules?
No, I think it's just, you know, be creative.
Okay.
Right? It's like Kelly was saying, it's a fun way to get to know the neighbors.
Yeah.
And the kids are working on some projects. These are all DIY things that you can do, too.
This is fun.
So these are inexpensive ways, things that you can do.
Okay.
Yeah, I love that. You get your kids involved, right?
Right.
This isn't a boo basket that mom needs to take on now, right? You're the ones that got booed with all the fun things. So, like, Kirsten's making, you know, he's looking out there. The boys are, you know, making their own boo tags.
Okay.
You can, like you said, let them know. Stickers. Kirsten's making a friendship bracelet. Taylor Swift made it popular. Let's put our friends' names on it. Let's do boo. Sophia's painting the pumpkins. And again, all those free printables, kind of just stuff, little pennants, the little added touches that say like, hey, I care about you. I'm invested in you. And then you can also elevate it by after they get all of that candy, right? Having somewhere to go.
Yeah. We actually put some things in the basket that maybe you had decor that you ended up not using, you know, this year on your stuff. And so like give it to them and then they're decorating their house and then everybody's kind of sharing that decor for Halloween that maybe you didn't use, which is kind of fun. So we did that. You know, you go to Target and you get like the dollar bin so people can add to their costumes something fun, like the glow bracelets and everything. So, but the one rule is that you have to make sure that you put that you've already been booed, right, in your window. So that's kind of a fun one as well.
Last fun thing is to a gift you get, right? Because the kids are going to be hopped up on candy.
On candy.
So let's get that energy out. Trade that candy. Something that we do too in our household is you can trade the candy in, then you give it to an organization. situation, but then give them a gift certificate to Kid Wonder. They can go do a ninja play. It's
so
the
fun.
Only San Diego's only American Ninja Warrior based gym for kids.
Oh, cool.
So they can.
Where is that?
They have four locations. There's one in Encinitas, Linda Vista, Allied Gardens, and the kids love it. They also have regular
Kid
gymnastics.
Wonder. Okay.
Yes.
All right.
They also have regular gymnastics classes.
Okay.
But again, get that energy out. Take some of the neighborhood kids with you too. All the parents will appreciate it.
Okay. All right. I'm putting you guys' information all on Fox5SanDiego.com under the Scene On tab in case you weren't taking notes from pajamas to Kid Wonder, because you're going to need that as soon as we have that fall break right around the corner. Don't you worry, mamas. We got you covered. Thank you, ladies, so much. And don't forget, it's fun to get through this time of year.